Hello guys, you are watching DevTech Solutions. If you haven't subscribed till now to our channel, please subscribe now. So let's get started. In this tutorial, we are going to connect our Java program with the MySQL database. So first of all, you need to install certain package. So if you are a Linux user, just open your terminal and type sudo apt-get install open JDK 8 JDK and then hit your password to become a super user. It says open JDK is already the newest version, so I don't need to reinstall it again. Now you are done with the Java development kit. Then you have to install the MySQL database server. So in order to set up MySQL, type sudo apt-get install MySQL server space MySQL client space lib MySQL hyphen Java, enter. As all these three packages are already installed on my system, so I don't need to reinstall it again. While installing the MySQL server, it will ask for you the root passwords. So enter your password according to your convenience. And then after you have entered your password and the MySQL is installed, you can just access it by MySQL space hyphen u. The default is the root user space hyphen p and then hit enter. Enter your password, whatever you have given while installing the MySQL server. And here I am. After entering the password, it will say, welcome to MySQL monitor. So let's zoom it a little bit more. And then you can just type sudo databases to check all the databases schema that are present here. These five databases are already there. So we are going to create a new database named a student. Type create database a student semicolon and then hit enter. It says query OK and one row affected. It means the database has been created. So you can just check your database by show databases. Here it is, the student database that we have just created. Then you can use the a student database, use a student and then hit enter. Then now you are using the a student database. So in the student database, show tables. When you type the show table, it says empty sets because in this database schema, there is no table. So we are going to create a new table named students with its ID that will be int type and auto increment. And the ID will be primary key. Then there will be first name, which will be of cat type, 20 size. And it will not null. And there will be last name, similarly 20 characters and not null. The small bracket, parenthesis and semicolon and hit enter. It says query is okay. Then we have successfully created the table name students. Then now we are going to insert a record in it. Insert into a student's values 1 Suraj Kumar. The syntax to install a record in the table is insert into table name values followed by your three parameters that are required in the table. And it says query is okay, one row affected. So we have successfully inserted the record into the table. You can just see it by select star from students, the table name, and here it is. The ID is 1, the first name is Suraj, and the last name is Kumar. So one, we have successfully inserted one record. So that's all for the database. We are going to fetch this information via the Java program. So let's exit our MySQL and we will go to our directory where we create our Java program. So let's make a new program. First application, then Emacs working first app dot Java. So now we are going to write a Java program. So first we need to import all the key classes that we have discussed in the previous tutorial, which are in the java.sql packages, and then we are going to define our class first app. We are going to write our main function. We are going to write every try catch block. So in case it throws an exception, the catch block will catch the exception and just show us what exception occurred. So first we are going to write the JDBC URL. JDBC connectivity followed by its driver protocol, then its driver connection details. That is, I am using the MySQL in my local system, so localhost followed by its port number, and my database name is student. A string username, which is by default for MySQL root Linux, and the password which I have for MySQL is suraj.odec. Give your own password here for your own MySQL respectively, and after that we are going to get a connection. That is a step 1. Then we are going to use the connection class, and then we are going to create a reference variable. My connection is equals to, we are going to use here a driver manager, driver manager dot get connection, then followed by your DB URL, username, password, enter. Then we are going to create a statement object, a step 2. We are using the statement class in the java.sql package. And we are using the my connection to create a statement. Now we are going to execute the query. Step 3. So whatever the query will be processed, it will be stored in the result set. So we are using the result set class. My result set is equals to my statement dot execute query. Just give your statement here, like star, select a star from a students, our table name, then close it. Now we are going to process the result set. So we are using the while block to process all the records, and using the myResultSet function dot next you are going to print the name of the student in the students table. So system.out println a student full name. Let's say I have a name, my result set dot get a string, and first we are calling the first name, and then a space between the first name and the last name, and my result set dot get a string last name. Then we are closing the while loop, and then we are closing the try block, and we are going to write the catch statement. And there we are going to print e.get message whatever the exception occurred, and then we are going to close our main function, and then we are going to close our class and save it. And now we are going to compile it by Java C, first app.java. So it has compiled successfully, so there is no syntax error in here. Now in order to run the application, you need a connector. So the driver manager you should be download from the dev.mysql.com downloads connector.j. Here is the link. You can just go here in the download section. Download the platform independent architecture independent compressed tar package for the Linux, and you can also check the zip package. So I will be downloading the tar package. So just click on the download to start downloading it, and then just click on no thanks, just start my downloads. And it will ask you where to download, so I will give you the directory to downloads and save it. And here it is already downloaded. So just close your browser and go to downloads. The downloads, there will be a tar package that you have downloaded. So just double click on it and extract it here. The downloads only. Here is my extracted package. So in there will be src as it is open source. So what we need is the jar file, MySQL connected java 5.1.43 bin jar. Just copy it here and go to your directory workspace JDBC where you have created your first application, and just paste in the class path directly and close it. So after, if I list it here, here is my source file, here is my bytecode, that is the dot class file, and here is my dot jar file which you will be needing to run the application, to connect the JDBC, to connect the Java application to the database. So to run it using the plain vanilla mode, java space hyphen cp for the class path, and then dot for current directory. In Linux you use colon, and in Windows you use semicolon. So for Linux we are using colon, and then MySQL as it reference, as it has a relative directory to this file system only, the first application we can directly access. Just type the colon and MySQL and just hit the tab button to get full read. After that get a space, and then first your class name, that is first app, and then hit enter. After hitting enter you get a result like after running the result java cp mysql connector.java and followed by its class name. This is the syntax to run the Java application which will be connected to the MySQL database. And after this it gives a message that on this date IST is Indian Standard Time and establishing SSL connection without server identity verification. So this is just a message that we get after the connection, and here it is the student full name which we have printed after processing the result set. So what we did was, overall, first we have installed all the necessary packages like OpenJDK for the Java to make the Java applications, and then MySQL Server. We install the MySQL Server, MySQL Client, and libmysql-java package to install the MySQL and to for the connectivity of the Java with the MySQL. Then after installing the MySQL Server, you will enter a you will ask for a password to enter it. Just write your own password of your own choice, and after that you can just access your MySQL account, create a database, then create a table and insert a single or two or four more record in it, and then write your Java application which will be talking with the database, and then compile it and use the syntax Java space hyphen cp dot colon MySQL connector, and then followed by your class name, and then it will be done. As I have successfully fetched the information from the database, here it is, the Suraj Kumar, the database. In the database we have inserted the first name and the last name was Suraj and Kumar. So that's all for this tutorial. Thank you for watching. Please like this video, and please comment and let us know your feedbacks. If you have any query, please do ask, and please subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching.